Well, the 1st of July is the birthday anniversary of Ignaz Philipp Semmelweis. As you probably know, Ignaz Philipp Semmelweis has invented the most important practice for infection control, which is hand hygiene. Hand hygiene able to reduce infection, but not only to reduce mortality in some cases. So we thought it would be unique to celebrate Semmelweis, so we asked 10 experts, the 10 most important experts in the world being around us, and tell us in 3 minutes what for them was Semmelweis' accomplishment, Semmelweis' legacy, and what would be the future of Semmelweis' action, and would Semmelweis be with us today, be happy.
Semmelweis spent the last 18 years of his life to convince people, his colleagues, to practice hand hygiene in an appropriate way. But he failed some way this mission because he died 18 years after the beginning of this work, very frustrated with many psychological problems and basically probably due to this situation as well. This very important message should be picked up, and our mission actually is to make hand hygiene best practiced around the world at every point of care, at every bedside.
But you know, in a sense, Semmelweis is a tragedy, you know? But with long-lasting, indisputable legacy, he spoke out the truth. Now, this is the legacy of Semmelweis. This is the legacy for all infection control. No matter how well developed and how noble we are, let's not forget, and let me now speak to all infection control colleagues, let's never forget to speak out when it's the truth, even when we have to pay the price.
It showed Semmelweis grabbing a doctor's hand when he walked on the ward and he was looking to see if his hands were clean or not. And this was sort of his early approach to try to get people to be more compliant with his recommendation. It didn't work very well though. It was probably the wrong strategy. So there's a lot we still have to learn about the best ways to convince our colleagues of the importance of hand hygiene and to do it on a regular basis.
In recent years, until the last few decades, people have not paid much attention to hand hygiene. So when you pay attention, you realize that it's not done as it should be, and it can be better, and it really works.
Nous avons été élevés dans un contexte où on dit si tu te laves trop les mains avec de l'eau et du savon, ça peut te rendre pauvre. Et là, ayant été à l'école et maintenant surtout dans un cadre de prévention d'hygiène des mains, là on se rend compte que la prévention des infections associées aux soins donc requiert l'hygiène des mains. Et contrairement à ce que ça peut laisser penser, ça sauve des vies, ça permet d'éviter beaucoup de maladies et surtout ça permet de faire de l'économie pour gagner beaucoup plus d'argent pour soi-même, pour son pays.
The message was that the fire hazard that our American colleagues claim is not true and lacks any kind of evidence. They installed dispensers and the fire marshal told them to remove all of them. So the hospital installed 300 dispensers at Mayo Clinic in Rochester, Minnesota, and 2 days later they had to remove the 300 dispensers.
The final message is that in my country we say now, well, bad hand hygiene is bad medicine, and we cannot tolerate bad medicine. There are consequences. And so with that, we have had good success with many of our doctors. They understand. They may not be happy with the change, but they will follow.
So if every healthcare worker is able to understand that message that is for their patient's safety, and they will do it. So secondly, the second message is, you know, the challenge is how to embed it in our culture of work so that hand hygiene is such a normal thing for each one of us to do, that it's part of our way we work. So once that happens, I believe, you know, we could really have a sustainable kind of a good compliance in our day-to-day work and therefore resulting in excellent patient safety for the patient we care.
I'm in charge for the German hand hygiene campaign. We have started with our campaign in 2008. We have meanwhile data for 4 years. And we were able to show that we have observed an increase of hand rub consumption of more than 30%. And I think this is a lot because it means change of behavior, and changing behavior is difficult.
Well, in fact, in Belgium we have already 4 hand hygiene campaigns, and the situation is always improving, but we have a plafond. That means that the hand hygiene compliance sticks at 70. So we have a new ID, and this last campaign we introduced movie clips that were presented in the hospitals, both for the patient but also for patient empowerment, but also to remind the role model of the medical doctors.
The main message this morning showing this video was that art has something to do in promotion of hand hygiene. And it was a very special moment to work together with the dance troupe to promote hand hygiene.